Welcome back, What's Inside. Today we are on a road trip and we're gonna cut open a meteorite.
Isn't it beautiful behind us? We decided to stop. We've been driving for like 5 hours already, but we're on our way to this giant crater near Flagstaff, Arizona. We bought this one on the internet and it's originally from Argentina, but about 9 hours away from our house is a giant hole in the ground from where meteorites hit thousands of years ago. So we wanna see it for ourselves. So we stopped at this place with these giant rocks everywhere. And I was reading some emails in the car for a few minutes and I'm like, where'd the kids go? And I open up the door, they're like, Dad, check this out. Can you see them up there? Where are they? There they are. They are way up there. All right, that guy right there is the real size of an astronaut next to the flag. And now I'm gonna zoom out so you can see how big this thing really is. That is how big it is. Walking in, we found this meteorite, and then we compared it to our meteorite that we paid $500 for. And look how tiny. This is part of a 150-foot meteor that fell here in Winslow, Arizona, about 50,000 years ago, they estimate. And the hole is gigantic. It's 500 feet deep and 4,000 feet wide.
This should be the last time we're filling up with gas on this trip. 19 hours in the car so we could stop at a crater for an hour and a half.
So this has been a great trip, and now it's time to go cut this meteorite in half, and then we have to go to a separate science lab and put nitric acid on the thing and see if we can get some cool patterns that would come out of it. We sat in the car for 19 hours. How was it, Lincoln?
It was fun because we listened to Harry Potter.
That's right. So we downloaded from audible.com, we went on there and we got Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone by J.K. Rowling. And the reason why we got this is because it is 8 hours and 33 minutes long.
It's like perfect, because that's how much we've been driving.
For one whole leg of the drive, we were able to listen to Harry Potter, and it made the drive seem like it went by so much faster. So we love audible.com. In fact, we reached out to them and they decided that they would sponsor this video and hook you guys up and hook us up with our own link. So show them some love, go to audible.com/whatsinside. You can get the Harry Potter for free, or any of the 180,000 titles for free for 30 days. Rock pick legends! We're here with our friend Rick, and he is an expert at cutting rocks. A lot of people might be wondering, like, why are we cutting open a meteorite?
We're gonna cut open a meteorite so that we can etch it out and find the Widmanstatten lines, the hatch patterns that form inside the meteorites, but you have to cut them and then you have to etch it with acid.
Okay, so we're gonna etch it with acid after this. That sounds very dangerous. We just saw the blade and that you can actually put your finger on there and it doesn't cut it, but yet it'll cut a meteorite.
It's kind of crazy.
That's cool.
It's pretty hot, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, so this is a diamond wheel polisher. It's designed for cutting or polishing rocks. We start with a very coarse grit and go to a super fine grit. The only way the Widmanstatten lines will show up is if we polish off all of the scratch marks from cutting it.
Here it is before, there's up close. Rick, great job. Check it out, they're polished. There's the inside of the meteorite. Now we need to take it and put the nitric acid on it and see if it'll etch. We often get a lot of comments saying, you guys are not safe, where's your PPE? Well, check this out. Glasses, fancy gloves, a jacket. Even though we have a YouTube channel, it's not significant enough to be able to purchase nitric acid off the internet. Odd, right?
Yeah.
So we got our friend Avon from GTI, and he is a science teacher here. Today when we were with Rick at the rock store, he told us that some meteorites, within 5 minutes, you'll see these great patterns that come out, and then other meteorites, you may not see anything. So this might be as good as it gets. And the sad thing is, once you put it in the nitric acid, the shine goes away.
There it goes, 10 mils, 5 mils in there. And now we have our 10% solution.
Lincoln, how do you feel about this whole thing?
Scared.
Scared? Okay, so we just cleaned it off. We're putting it in the acid, getting really close. If it explodes, you'll have a close-up view of it. It's kind of, it looks like kind of green.
It's starting to turn a little yellow greenish. The greenish comes from the nickel oxide, so it's etching some of the nickel out.
Awesome.
And then it should also be etching some of the iron out, and that's going to be rust. That's going to be iron oxide.
Science.
Yeah, there's something.
I don't really see any patterns in there yet. It just kind of looks black. That tells me something is happening.
Yeah.
I know what's happening. The aliens are coming out of the meteorite. They've been in there for 5,000 years. They're finally coming out. What do you think?
Probably.
Good dad joke?
Probably we have to swipe it and then a genie's gonna come out.
Yeah. How does it look? Oh, it's looking better now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's looking much better.
Okay, there's put it back
still
in.
A bit of black on the side.
Okay, that's promising. I was a little worried at the beginning.
Yeah,
it was
totally
just black. But then Avon, our scientist, he was smart enough. He's like, let's just put some more nitric acid in it. So he put some more nitric acid in it, made the concentration a little higher, and now it's actually etching it.
That's looking weird. So how much nitric acid do you have to blow something up?
I don't feel comfortable answering that, but this is what you use to make TNT.
So take a look at that. You can see some of the patterns, the Widmanstatten pattern, I guess. Here's the one that's been etched in the nitric acid. Here's the one that wasn't. And yes, it's not as shiny, but you can also see these different patterns that kind of come out of it. This was an awesome project. We also want to remind you guys to look in the description below and use the link that they gave us to hook you guys up with a free audiobook or 30 days for free. And it's audible.com/whatsinside.
What whose is this?
That is mine. It's a meteorite.
No kidding.
Yeah?
So how did you obtain that?
I bought it off eBay for $500.
Really?
I'm gonna cut it open for a YouTube video.
Is that right?
Yeah, it makes cool patterns inside when you cut it open. So.
I did not know that.
It's terrible.
Cool, wow. Right?
Or around it, something.